Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this learning objective video, we will be discussing the anatomical planes, which is exactly what our learning objective says, so let's get right into it. Many of the anatomical descriptions that we discussed in the previous video are really based on these four imaginary anatomical planes, so we will discuss each one of these four right here. Starting with the median plane, because I think the median plane is one of the more intuitive ones to understand. And this is a vertical plane. You can see this right here is the median plane. Kind of just see it kind of going through this region right here. The median plane is a vertical plane that passes longitudinally through the midline of the body. So it's actually defining what the midline of the head, the neck, and the trunk is. The term midline is often used interchangeably with the median plane, but that isn't exactly right because think about it, when you consider the midline of, say, the upper and the lower limbs, that's not quite it. Sagittal planes will pass through the body parallel to the median plane. So you can have multiple sagittal planes, just as long as they're parallel to the median. You will sometimes hear the term parasagittal, but really any sagittal plane is parallel to the median plane. So para is really just an added and unnecessary prefix, but this doesn't mean you won't hear it. And you may also hear the term paramedian, which is any sagittal plane that is kind of near or particularly near to the median plane. So I'd argue that the sagittal plane that we're looking at here is actually, could be considered paramedian. In anatomy, we will just use the term sagittal, but wanted to introduce parasagittal and paramedian in case you hear it in other clinical contexts. The frontal or coronal planes will run at right angles to the median plane. So think that median plane is running through here. And so your frontal plane is running at right angles to that median plane. The frontal plane will divide the body, or the frontal planes will divide the body into anterior and posterior parts, or front and back parts. So you can see that this would be more anterior back here, and this would be more posterior. There is a cranial suture that actually runs right about here-ish, called the coronal suture. So think crown of the head, and so that's where that coronal, those two names mean the same thing. Lastly, the only horizontal planes are the aptly named horizontal or transverse planes, which will run at right angles to both the frontal and the median planes. Now, this particular image is just showing one transverse plane, but you can have them anywhere throughout the body. And this will divide the body into superior and inferior portions. And sometimes that superior portion can be really small in comparison to the inferior portions, or vice versa. So you'd have a very large superior portion here and a really small inferior portion if you're looking at this particular transverse plane. You may hear transverse planes referred to as axial or transaxial planes, particularly in radiology. All right, so that should do us regarding the anatomical planes. As always, we end with this summary slide. That is always a nice, concise slide to return to for reference or for studying. Thank you for your time and attention, and please always feel free to reach out with any questions. Have a great day.